Hi, my name is Lukas von Stockhausen, and today I would like to show you a new feature which we implemented with our SCA 20.2 release, and this is Python imports. Before we go into the presentation, let me please quickly kick off this demonstration script here so we can have a look at this later on. And you see that the FPR files have been deleted in this folder, so this is running right now. Talking about Python, with 20.2, we have updated our support for Python up to 3.8. But this is not really what I would like to talk about here today. What I would like to talk about is our improved imports for Python. So what we did actually is we worked on the possibilities of how to import Python namespaces and Python libraries during the scan. What you see here is a simple script, which I'm running, where in the first case, I'm deleting the existing FPR files. This is what we just saw. And then you see that I first run our code base with our 20.1 analyzer. And then secondly, with the current 20.2 analyzer. And you see as well that I'm just scanning here the local files in the directory with a very small example, which can showcase what's going to happen. So you see here really a very easy translation and then running the scan. You see here already as a preview in the slide that in 20.1, we actually get a warning that there is an import missing, not found NS package. So this is not available and it has not been named. Previously, we would have in 20.1, we would have to clearly define that package. You see here this error message in 20.2 is actually not available anymore or not existing anymore. So let's have a look at our scan, and we see here the executed scan. So exactly what we have just seen in the screenshots. We see here in 20.1, using the 20.1.0 build here, we see this warning being available and telling us that something is not ideally working. And that actually results into not having any issues being found in this small example. As you can see here with 20.2, we do not have any warning message anymore. And on top of that, we are finding an issue due to have complete coverage on Python right now. So if we look here, right, this is our result set in 20.1, no issues being found. In 20.2, we find a system information leak, which clearly shows the complete data flow through the application here. And here we have the NS package module. With that, I would like to thank for your attention, and I hope you find this new feature useful. And I'm looking forward to your feedback. Thank you, and have a great day.